Hello everyone, in today's session we will cover another informative topic in finance, in Dynamics 365 Finance, and the topic is also very useful, and the name of topic is allocation terms. And in this video we will define how to define the allocation terms or allocation rules, and how we can use them. My name is Peer Khuram Rashti and I'm Microsoft Certified Trainer. So we'll start with the introduction of the topic about allocation terms. Then we'll discuss one scenario, and then the procedure, how to create the allocation terms, and that will be followed by the demonstration. So basically, in the introduction, I would like to introduce allocation terms, which are basically used to divide, or you can say distribute, the value from one main account and financial dimension combination to multiple ledger account combinations, that is main account plus financial dimensions. Whenever we say ledger account in Dynamics 365 Finance, so it means main account plus the financial dimension as a whole can be called a ledger account. Previously it was only a ledger account, but now since for bifurcation or reporting purpose we have financial dimension defined in the account structure or advanced rules linked with the main account, so as a whole we can call it as a ledger account. So allocation terms can allow us to distribute values when they are posted into one main account and financial dimension combination to many ledger account, and that is main account plus financial dimensions. So the core purpose is basically realistically charge the expenses or revenue value so that there can be main accounts, more main accounts and financial dimensions where this value can be divided or charged. So instead of charging and parking all the value into one account and financial dimension, the system allows us to divide it and distribute it among the multiple ledger accounts. So allocation rules can be also used. Allocation rule allows us basically to define the percentage of a voucher for allocation. So it can be from one ledger account to another ledger account. So maximum percentage can be definitely 100%. You cannot go beyond that. But within that percentage, for example, if you want to divide one value of expense, say 30% into one, 30% to another, so it will be 60% in total. So 40% remaining, it depends upon you. You want to divide that one also, or you, if you don't divide it, so it will be retained in the source account. So as here also in the last point, I have defined ledger account can be main account plus the financial dimension when we talk about D365 Finance. So there are options like specific or unspecific available in the source financial dimension, because in the rule, in the allocation rule, you define the selection criteria or the filter criteria, where a specific means a specific value whenever it is selected for a financial dimension, then that will be picked up, or unspecific means any value in that financial dimension is used. So also for the target ledger account, can be a same main account, or it can be a different main account. And for the financial dimension also, the system gives you ability to keep the value as same as the source voucher. So it means the financial dimension value, whatever it is in the source dimension, you can keep it as same, or you can divide it into another one. Means you can select another one, and you can say 30% is into this one, or for that purpose you need to select no. So we will see in demonstration how it happens. So now just for theory purpose, you just need to know this is for the target. Okay, so unlimited allocation rules can be defined. But some of percentage, as I earlier told, that it cannot be more than 100% for the obvious reasons, because the total is definitely 100%. You cannot go beyond that one. So if you define less than 100%, so the remaining percentage will be kept in the source financial dimension as of the original voucher. So it will not be divided or distributed. So allocation rules are also legal entity specific, and the allocation rules for a shared chart of account should be defined for each of the legal entity. So there is one when you go to the main account form in the general ledger, so you have the option to define a legal entity, and against that legal entity there will be a allocation checkbox which need to be selected in order to enable the allocation terms button which is available there. So if you don't select this allocation checkbox, so allocation terms button will not be enabled. So scenario is just like a cost center 007 trade shows. Whenever it is selected in a vendor invoice journal, the expense should be divided between marketing campaign and 009, that is service operation, equally, or you can say 50% each. So this above scenario we will implement in our demonstration. So for that we need to define basically two allocation rules, and each of the allocation rules will have 50% allocation, and in that one one row we'll define for 008 and one for 009 for the target cost center. So source criteria will be specific only for the cost center, that is 007. So here we will basically change the value, and it will be 008 and 009 each for different rules. So here keep source financial dimension will be as yes for rest of financial dimension except the cost center. For the cost center we will keep source financial dimension be selected as no, and then two lines will be created, or two rows will be created each for 008 and 009. The only difference will be the cost center in allocation rules. Okay, so for defining allocation rules, you can go to general ledger, chart of accounts group, and then in the accounts section, you can find the main accounts page or main account form. The whole procedure will be showing you in demo. There is an optional option of copying the allocation rules in order to duplicate the same allocation rules for another place if it is defined in a previous main account. So for allocation terms, D35 will create another voucher which will basically match with the source financial dimension whenever the selection criteria is matched. So now we'll start with the demo. So we are in Dynamics 365 Finance and Operation Environment. Here we will go to, first of all, General Ledger. Okay, I will collapse all the sections here. And here we can first go to the ledger, to the chart of account. And in the chart of account, we can go to the accounts. And here we can go to the main accounts. First, we need to find the expense account. So I will just put a filter of expense, and here we can see there is an account called fuel expenses 601505. So here on the right hand side you can see at the bottom ledger entity overrides option is available. So here we can click the button add, and then we'll select the legal entity which is USMF and select add. And now you can see on the right hand side there is an allocation checkbox. Just select this checkbox, then allocation terms will be enabled. If you don't select this, so allocation terms are disabled. So I will select this, and then I will go to the allocation terms. Okay, so the first one here, so I can create as many as I like, up to 100%. So I will select first allocation rule to be 50%. Okay, so this above pane defines, which is the first tab, defines selection criteria, that is a filter criteria you can call it. And at the bottom you can see destination ledger account, that is the target value where we need to set is available in order to define it. So here we will just make it, instead of a specific, unspecific means any of the value if it is in the voucher. for the business unit financial dimension, so it will be ignored. Okay, for the cost center, we need to specify here, which is the trade show 007. So we will select this one. Okay, so department any value, item group any value, project any value. We are not concerned about that. If whenever a voucher is posted against this main account 601505, that is in fuel expense, whenever a voucher is posted in this account, so then it will see whether the cost center is 007. So if it is 007, what it will do, so I will not select here two account, but you can have the option to select another two account, like another expense account, and you can move that value percentage wise to that main account plus the financial dimension. So here in two account I will define the same main account, which is fuel expense. Okay, so this account is selected here. So keep source financial dimension. Okay, so there will be a warning that it will show you that same main account here is selected, so additional journal entries might be generated. So just ignore this. So it is just giving you warning because this is might be not a typical flow. Normally you would be allocating maybe to another account, so but since I'm selecting this same account, so it is giving me a warning. No problem, just ignore it. Go to the business unit and keep it yes. So it means the source financial dimension will remain same, it will not be changed. However, you have the option to change it, so then it will be changed. So if you don't select it yes and select no and give a value, so it will be selected when generating a new voucher against this allocation. So in the cost center I will select no, and remaining I will select yes, because I want to keep all the values same as it is in the cost center. So I need to here select two values, first marketing campaign, then I will create another rule and I will select service operations. So here I will select marketing campaign. So it means 50% whenever the cost center is trade show, it will be divided to the marketing campaign. So I will create another allocation rules, and here I will also enter 50, and I will be selecting unspecific. And in the cost center again, the trade shows as previous allocation rules, here also unspecific, any value in the filter criteria. Okay, so here again fuel expenses. Okay, so then in the business unit select yes and ignore the warning again. No problem, ignore and keep source for department item group, because we want to keep the same value. And for the cost center, here what we'll do is we'll select 009, that is service operations. Okay, so these two allocation rules are 50-50, so it means up to 100% in total we have defined total, we cannot go beyond that one. Okay, so the allocation rules are now defined against this main account. So what we'll do is we'll create a vendor invoice journal. So for that, go to accounts payable. In the accounts payable, go to the invoice, and in invoice journal we'll create another invoice, a new invoice journal. Invoice journal can be used when you don't have any purchase order, so it can be directly just like free tax invoices on the customer side without a sales order. So similarly you can create a vendor invoice journal without a purchase order. So here I will select accounts payable invoice. Okay, I will go to the lines. So once lines are open, so I will go and select a vendor account. So I can select SEME office supplies here, and the invoice date I will select today, and then invoice number I must give here. So it will be 14/01/2023, and invoice for allocation terms. Okay, so here I will define only 1000 USD. In the offset account, I will replace this one with the fuel expenses. Just remove the value here. So I will select this fuel expenses, and business unit anyone I can select here, department also anyone I can select, because we have defined unspecific. But in the cost center it will be 007, because in our filter criteria we have selected this one. And for the item group I will just ignore the item group. So now we have defined the offset account, which fulfills our selection criteria. So the cost center is important here, and the main account is important here, which matches with our filter criteria and allocation rules. So once I have defined this, I will just remove the cash discount, and also for the simplicity purpose, I will remove any taxes. And then I will just check the journal. So I'll click OK in order for the report to just show us the journal. So I will enlarge it, and you can see here that the vendor is credited, the accounts payable is credited, and the debit goes to the fuel expenses here, 1000. And here are the ledger account breakdown. So credit goes to accounts payable other, and the debit goes to the fuel expenses. Okay, so now we will just validate the journal so that there are no errors, and once validated we can post it. So the validation is successful and journal is okay. So I will just now post the vendor invoice journal. Okay, so the journal is now posted, and we can see here the voucher is enabled. We will go to the voucher and see what are the transactions. So here we can see that these are basic transactions, and you can see that there are two additional transactions generated here of the allocation type, and that is the additional entry which has been generated. So basically this accounts payable here, it is credited, and then the debit goes to the expense account with the selection of 007. And then there are two further allocations for this expense as we have defined in the allocation rules. One into 009 cost center. So 009 belongs to service operations, and then one into 008, that is marketing campaign. So that is how it has balanced, and for balancing these two, it has also created another allocation transaction on the credit side. So because these are on debit side, so it need to balance by the credit side allocation type of transaction. In this way, we have actually divided or distributed our expenses further into appropriate or realistic cost centers. So this is a very useful feature, and it can be used for the allocation for the expenses and revenue into further, you can say, the ledger account. Different ledger account means the main account plus the financial dimension combination, or by keeping the same main account but distributing to different financial dimensions. So I'm hopeful this was a useful thing for you, useful feature in Dynamics 365. If you have any comments, just let me know. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye.